The CDC has called it an epidemic. Drug overdoses, often due to toxic supply, continue to escalate here in Winnipeg. Advocates are calling for efforts towards harm reduction to help save lives. Morgan Majeski with part one of our series, A City in Crisis.
Harming them financially, physically, mentally, not caring.
It's evening in Winnipeg, and inside a small container used to carry prescription pills, three small baggies are pulled from inside as a man details what people might go through to secure these substances.
They'll be put into situations that they never thought were reality, that don't exist, that they don't hear about mainstream. People setting people up completely as marks.
People are dying from overdoses in Winnipeg more and more every year. The number of drug-related calls being responded to by the Winnipeg Fire and Paramedic Services has risen significantly in recent years, specifically for drugs like crystal meth and opiates.
Meth calls are up 234%, while opiate calls have jumped by 430% since 2016. Those in the know, like this man who provided the drug sample, says the situation has reached a crisis level for anyone trying to survive in what he calls Winnipeg's toxic drug environment.
People are dying everywhere from it.
He says his connections in the city allow him to secure drugs that are relatively safe, but he says it takes time and patience to find a safe substance, and for most, finding drugs in the city can be a very dangerous gamble.
You get people cutting stuff with fentanyl mainly lately has been the main, you know what I mean, the killer, the absolute. It's been a complete epidemic.
He says what we held in our hands could kill a person. Unlike highly regulated alcohol, tobacco, and marijuana, street drugs have been pushed underground. And while they're used in all walks of life, many people that turn to them are often systematically oppressed and heavily marginalized.
Most people do get robbed on the street. People can tell by, you know, people walking up where they're from, just by the way they walk, where they're from, what they do for a living, what their vulnerabilities are, you know. People are experts in body language and, psychology, and there's a lot of malicious people out there.
In November, a gathering on the steps of the Manitoba legislature marked a grim milestone, 199 deaths in the first half of 2021 due to overdoses, an increase of more than 44% over the same time frame in 2020. Many in the province advocating for harm reduction say a supervised consumption site where people can do drugs with medical assistance and access critical services is needed to save lives. It's an approach even those involved in the black market say would make an impact.
Absolutely. Have things in place that where people will be safe. Something wrong happens that they'll, you know, it can be corrected right there and then.
This ceremony, laying carnations to represent those lost to overdoses, coming just weeks after Winnipeg City Councillors reviewed a report about the possibility of a supervised consumption site.
There's consumption occurring. It's without anything organized, resourced, or funded, then that's the kind of consumption sites one might expect to see. So it was a pretty consistent theme that it's going to be happening. It's a question for governments of where they would like it to happen and what level of harm reduction they would actually like in place as it happens.
The city's chief administrative officer stressing to councillors the purpose of a supervised consumption site is not just about providing easier access to drugs.
It's if a model that would only allow or facilitate the use of the substance with nothing further isn't really something that those involved in harm reduction want to be a part of. That if it's not an entry point into a continuum of care, if it's not an entry point into a pathway to better health outcomes, then it's an exercise in futility. It's just helping people continue to do the substances that are dragging them down.
Advocates say a supervised consumption site will help keep people safe and prevent further deaths from happening in the city. It will also serve as an access point for those who are ready to get help. But they note not everyone who uses the site will be ready to get off of drugs, and as a result, it will also serve as a service hub providing critical services like drug testing. In Winnipeg, Morgan Majeski, City News.